What's up, everybody? Tuesday, April the 19th, 2011. Get back in the groove Tuesday. I'm back with the FJT, the feature Jordan of today, and the nine-number Jordan shoe battle number 10. Yesterday, in battle number 9, which was an elimination battle, the Air Jordan 5 defeated the 9.5 team, eliminating the 9.5 and Rocky from the competition. The Air Jordan Force 5 will move on to the next round. Remember, Kicks Bowl 2011, Dallas, Texas, Saturday, July the 2nd, 2011, from 4 p.m. to 10 p.m. at Dallas Cowboys Stadium. Tickets are $15, hosted by Mayor. Some special guests on the list are Franelations, DJ Greg Street, Verbal, My Soul to Keep, Sticky 213, Vic Lloyd, Soul and Love, The Clink Room, myself, and others will be in the building. Come check us out. Today's battle is another elimination battle. We'll get to that in 1 second. I'm going to give a big shout out and rest in peace to Kenneth up in Kenneth's Corner. Much love to him. Let's jump off into this battle today. That is on deck. The brackets, how they're working out. Tomorrow, I need shoes for the Air Jordan Force 3 and the Spizikes. Hit me up so I can pull your shoes and have them on deck. Today is a win or go home battle between the 12.5s and the Mellows. Here we go. You already know what's at stake. The 2007 Mellow M3, represented by Bejuno 10, taking on the 2008 Jordan 12.5 team, represented by Twist 1298. Win or go home battle on deck today. Let's take it straight to the foot game, because a lot of times that's what it takes for people to decide which shoe they want to roll with. Also today, I have my doctor's appointment to find out what the status is with my back and what they want to do. So wish me luck with that, and I will keep you updated on that situation and pray for the best. All right, on the left, the 12.5, the black, metallic silver, and university blue, and on the right, the Mellow, aka the birthday Mellow white, varsity red, and black. Bottoms. A little deeper look. There you have it. Take your time to vote. Leave a comment if you would like. Appreciate the participation of everyone in these battles and the support on the page. Now, we're going to move on to the feature Jordan of the day. The 1996 Columbia Blue 11, 130-245-141, retail for $124.95. And here is the trusty Soul Collector magazine, issue 22 from February of 2000. 2008. 1996 release. We know the Concords came out in 1995. And this is a look at the other releases and the samples. The original box that they came with. Breaking down on me a little bit. $19.96 release, as I stated, $125. The first shoe to start the second three-peat of the Bulls. The 11 had a striking style, and the style of a shoe stepped into technology in a major way. The patent leather was used for the first time in a performance shoe and added level of support unavailable through traditional leathers or suede. It has a ballistic mesh upper, which added to the element of weight reduction and aided in breathability. The crowning achievement in the 11 is the use of full-length carbon fiber shank plates on the bottom. This was one of the first hoop shoes to use this technology. The shoe offered increased midfoot support, greater impact distribution, and a level of energy return. The Concord landed in late 95 and is a favorite of the 11 family. The 11 retroed rather quickly, coming back just 5 years after the OG. The 2000 Space Jam retro with the 23 on the heel, but there is a sample 45 version of the 11s that remain one of the most coveted collector's items and rumored to be coming out later this year in December. The 2006 Defining Moments 11 is still one of the most sought after shoes of the 11 Jordan family. It's reported that the Jordan 11s are the most counterfeited of all Jordans. The 11 is probably the hottest shoe ever by Jordan brand, and the patent leather is the leading reason why. MJ won his fourth NBA title wearing this shoe, and it's the first title he won after the death of his father wearing these shoes. All right. The featured Jordan of the day, 1996 Columbia 11s. All right, there we have it. The word of the day, of the morning, is ego. If people with disagreements of any kind could control their inner ego and just let it go, a lot of ego-related problems could be solved easily. If you just communicate and stop feeling, you will be considered weak or a punk. If you just give in, talk about it, communicate about it, work out whatever the minor situation is, because a lot of times it's minor. If it's something major, you know that it's going to be more difficult to deal with. But if it's something minor that you can work out, why stretch the beef out when you know one person or both of you at the same time will need to step up? It's a better man who steps up first and apologizes, because that other person be like, dang, I should have did it first. Just something to think about. It's your boy, Jumpman, fading to the back from the basement of the J's. I'll holler at you later on tonight with another shoe as we work our way up to 703. Have a good day. Peace.